Hey, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going through my entire handbag collection. I didn't realize until I had everything laid out what I have and what I'm missing. So this video is entirely for fun. I'm not saying I have a perfect handbag collection and you should therefore emulate mine, but if I have a couple pieces, then I wanna make sure that I share them. I definitely have some favorites that I'm very excited to share. But if you're new, welcome. I'm Jules. I do videos every week on fashion, style, and shopping, so please subscribe if you haven't already, and let's get started. So I also wanna make this video really helpful. So I'm going to show you what kind of stuff can fit in some of these bags. This is the wallet I currently use, just because I use so many crossbodies that a bigger wallet like this doesn't fit. And my keys, I know I have a ton of keys. I hear about it all the time. All of them will be linked down below in the description box. I know not all of them will be still sold because some of them are very old, but I'll have some similar ones linked. Those links do support my channel, so thank you so much if you choose to use them. But if not, that's totally fine. I am gonna break this up into categories. This first category I'm calling my convertible category because they can be worn in different ways. So I wanna start off with this one. This is a convertible crossbody or shoulder bag. Yeah, see, all of them are gonna be similar styles. I love chain details on bags. This one is from Mango, so it's very affordable. At first, I wasn't super in love with the bag, but it has definitely grown on me. It's not the highest quality bag you've ever met, but at the same time, it has a nice, sturdy, solid finish. It doesn't like really easily cave in, and that structure is something I've come to really appreciate. Next up, we have this bag. This is from Red Dress, and it is clearly a dupe for the Chanel reissue. 255. I can't remember. I've done a whole video on it actually. It has this maroon on the inside. It's literally the same in size as the Chanel, except without the Chanel and kind of without the quality, but it's really durable. The one thing you can see is there is some wear right around here. You only see it when you open it, so it's very little time that you actually see that wear. The straps are convertible. They're a bit tough to convert, but you can. And then you could wear it kind of crossbody like this. I like to use this sometimes for events. For my job, I sometimes go to events and have to work at events. And so you want something that's crossbody where you can hold stuff that you need. Next, we have another convertible crossbody shoulder bag. This one is from H&M. H&M is one of my favorite places to find just like nice little trendy crossbody bags. I have a few that I'll be sharing. This one I think is by far my favorite. I don't think they sell it anymore. I will double check, of course, but I love this color and I love the suede with the faux leather. It just looks beautiful. It matches everything. You can wear this with a dark outfit, a light outfit. It's great for running errands, but I've also dressed it up in the past. I wasn't quite sure what section to put this bag in, but I eventually ended on convertible because you can wear it as a crossbody, but you could also just take off this crossbody chain and kind of wear it as a mini bag and carry it by the top handle. This one is from Amazon. This is one of the best handbag purchases I've made just because of the price. It is so amazingly inexpensive and it looks so cute. It just instantly adds a pop of stud, you know, a pop of gold, a little pop of black, some nice contrast to an outfit. It makes it look really edgy. But this bag barely fits my compact wallet. I cannot tell you how many times I've been at a register trying to get my wallet out of this thing and people are like, wow, that wallet barely fits into that bag. And I'm like, you can hate if you want. This thing is like $12. I also want to mention this bag that I just got. It would go in this category, but it hasn't arrived yet. I'm really excited for it. I've been wanting a houndstooth handbag to add to my collection. I'm kind of obsessed with houndstooth. Has a convertible chain strap, which as I just said, is one of my favorites. So I'll have that link down below, but again, make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that one coming up in a haul very soon. All right, so next we have the evening bag section. This first one is one I got for a super steal. This is by Sam Edelman. I really like the YSL style bags, but haven't quite got the guts to splurge that money yet. So this was a good substitute for now, but this bag is definitely one of my favorites for evening. I can't remember if it fits. It does, but it definitely protrudes a little bit, but it has enough kind of space down here where it's not too big of an issue. But when I try to fit my keys in here, it definitely starts getting a little lumpy. So that's when you make someone else drive. So moving on, I wasn't sure where this bag should go. It could have gone, I think, in any of these categories except the large bag category. But I put it in evening because it's definitely a little bit more elegant. It is this chain link shoulder bag. This is from H&M. Again, love to buy trendy bags from H&M. I was really looking for one that had a chain but also could be used as like one, what do they call them? Like a cloud clutch, where it's just like all this bunched up material right here. And you could wear it under your arm. I wish the chain was detachable for that reason. Amazon also sells a version of this bag that has square links if you're interested in that option. Next up, I have this beige snakeskin bag from Target. This one I really liked because, again, it's convertible, which I guess it could have gone in the convertible section, but it's definitely more of an evening bag to me. I like to use it more as a clutch. The inside lining is absolutely gorgeous. It's like this blush mauve color. Linings add such a nice touch to a bag, even though very few people actually end up seeing them. I think they just make it feel a little extra special. This clutch is one of my favorites and I want to get it in more colors, but I think I got it a few years ago, so I'm not sure if they still sell this style. You can definitely see we've got some jean wear here on the side, but it is bright orange, which is definitely not in my color scheme, but I love it for just a pop of color if you're looking to just spice up a outfit you wear a lot. I also use this a lot for events. It's a perfect one you can just wear across your body and keep what you need, but it still looks really polished at the same time. This chain does come off, so if you want to wear it under your arm, you totally can, but I definitely want to get this in some neutrals because it's such a versatile bag, but sometimes the orange does hold me back. These next ones I'm going to show all at once because they're all from Charming Charlie, so they're a bit old, but at the same time, like, Charming Charlie's back, so I don't know what is available and not. This is just a metallic clutch, adds a pop of metallic. It's kind of a blush rose gold. This one is for when I want a pop of leopard print. It's a nice wristlet, so I can keep, you know, a few cards, my phone, or if I'm at a hotel, I can keep my hotel key in there, and it just keeps it really simple. This is kind of the same thing, but it's a little bit more everyday, but I kept it in the evening section because of the wristlet. But this one I would definitely say is the most versatile of all of them because it can be dressed up and down. All right, our next section is all about crossbodies, but they're ones that you can't convert. So to start us off with one of my favorites, this is just a puffy crossbody. I freaking love this bag. It perfectly fits all of my receipts and it fits my compact wallet here. Keys, lip gloss, literally anything you need for just a day of running errands. It's super, super soft and plushy. I am loving the puffy trend, so I love this bag. It's a great everyday bag, but it doesn't fit longer wallets. It looks like it might, but again, way, way, way too long. Next is not quite a crossbody, but I didn't know where else to put it. It is a belt bag, right? We call them belt bags. I was gonna say fanny pack. I'm like, no, don't say it. I prefer to wear these across the body, so I guess it could work for a crossbody rather than a full-on belt bag, but you totally can. Again, an H&M find because it is such a trend. I knew with a belt bag, I wanted a chain just like this one. It's very similar to this one, but as you can see, they're still very different, even though they are very similar. Next up, we have this raffia bag. These are so popular every spring and summer. Like, I swear, I don't know how many people on Instagram I see with bags like this or just like this. This is a good one to have in your arsenal, if I'm completely honest. Over time, it does kind of start to turn green. Past summer was my second summer, I think, with this bag. I got this one off Amazon, and Amazon is where you find this bag for a lot cheaper than you can find it at other places. But Amazon prices can change, so, you know, no guarantees. You can fit, you know, your compact wallet, your keys, anything you want, but, you know, keep in mind that it is not zipped shut. This thing can pop off, but I have found it to be pretty secure, and it just looks really cute with all the skirts and dresses that you're wearing. On a similar note, we have this crossbody bag, which also has a woven texture to it. I love it. It has this bit bridal logo emblem on it. It's from H&M, and I've seen a lot of bags with H&M have this, and so I've actually been keeping myself from buying a lot of H&M bags because I don't want this on everything, but it looks nice. I have nothing against it. I just don't want it all over all of my bags. It looks like it could be convertible. It has these things, but I can't figure out what the point of it all is if you can't do anything with it. Like, could you convert it into a little top thing like this? I don't know, because I can't figure out why we have these little bars here and how this all works. So if you know, can you please let me know? Because I've been trying to figure it out. There's no loops on the inside. I'm also including this bag more so as a point to show that a handbag collection is always a work in progress. And even though if you like something at one point and it's been really useful in the past, it might not always fit your aesthetic going forward or what you want going forward, and that's fine. It can find a new home. This is a bag I sometimes like to travel with, not for work, but more for pleasure. Just because it can fit what you need, it goes across your body, it keeps your hands pretty free. Okay, so moving on to the bigger handbags of the section, I do need to say a disclaimer that this is kind of an interesting section with a lot of weird things about every single item, and you'll see why. But to start us off, we have this small woven tote. This is from Draper James, which is Reese Reese Witherspoon's company. I got this as part of my FabFitFun box. This was actually part of the last FabFitFun box I got. I ended up canceling my order after receiving this bag, and I don't mean that as any kind of diss. I think Draper James is a wonderful brand. I think FabFitFun is a wonderful brand. But when I got this, this made me realize that I would have rather more handpicked the kind of bag I would have gotten for this. And I like this bag, but it doesn't really fit into my lifestyle all that well. But the main reason I say that is because when it comes to totes like this, I don't like ones that are completely open. This is really cute. If you like this kind of style and you're okay with just a magnetic closure, then that's great. But I at least like having one large compartment that has a zipper on it for just some added security. But please don't get me wrong, this is a really nice bag. It's super cute. There's just a couple little details on it, as someone who is very picky, that makes it not quite perfect for me. I cannot talk about my handbag collection without mentioning this puppy right here. This is like one of my favorite bags, and it's pretty expensive, I'm not gonna deny it. This is my work tote. I use this thing hard, and I take good care of it, and it hasn't been used that hard over the last 8 or 9 months or however long this has been. But I've done a whole series of videos just on this bag in general, so I'm not gonna go into it here, other than I still have it and I still love it. I'm also really excited because I asked for this backpack for Christmas, and I might have heard from a little birdie that it's coming. This is the Calpak backpack. So if you wanna see more of it, I'm sure it will be in an upcoming video after Christmas. But I have had my eye on this bag for the last year. This one has compartments for your laptop, and all the compartments are really secure. I'm always a little paranoid about, you know, backpacks and pickpockets and that sort of thing. And then this is my Louis Vuitton Aina PM handbag. Again, I've done a whole series of videos just on this bag, and so I'll have those linked down below as well if you want to check them out and see exactly what fits in there. This doesn't fit a laptop. My work tote does. This does not, but it does fit an iPad if you use an iPad instead. Anyway, I just wanted to mention it here. I know this isn't affordable, but it's part of my handbag collection. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up down below. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you're subscribed, and I can't wait to see you in my next video. Bye!